We've all been looking for, and it's a test of the carpenter's skill to get this slotted in and everything to be the correct size into this wee space. Now, we are now inside the boat, and as you can see, there are planks inside the boat as well as in the outer shell, but not quite so many, as this gives it the strength to withstand any knocks and the boat might have in its working day. There was a very unusual sight to see, a spirit level on a boat. It was very, very rarely you could use a spirit level on the boat while you were building it, because the keel might not be at the level anyway, and there's so much curves on the boat that you just could not use it. Now here you see the carpenter feeding in the oakum into the seam between the keel and the plank. The oakum might come in bales, and you might have to spin it yourself before you can use it. This was quite a job in its own, and not everybody had the knack of pulling it and teasing it out and spinning it. If you hadn't the knack, you broke it off more times than you kept it in a roll. And as you can see, if you don't keep it in a roll, you'll have too much tails at the end of the day. Here is a good example of the special mallet you use to do the caulking. It was a wooden mallet with a heavy ring in each end to stop the end from spreading. And really a straightforward kind of job once you got used to it. This is a good shot of the fore end of the boat when it is fully planked. And now again you have the carpenter coming to put in the oakum. You see how he drops his hand and lifts it up and then taps it into the seam. Once he finishes tapping it into the seam as such, he will change on to a different tool and then he will come back and knock it into the seam. Depending how thick your seam is, you might have to do this 3 or 4 times. But that looks quite a sensible seam, and he will be trying maybe to get his three rows of oakum in there. Now you see this young man feeding the oakum into the seam with the different tool I was telling you about. The oakum must be sticking a wee bit because I think I saw him drop his tool into the box of oakum with oil in it that he would have by his side. This is a very gentle way of putting the oakum in, because when you were under pressure to get your work done, a day's work done in a day, you would have gone 2 or 3 times faster than that while you was putting the oakum into the seam. Now this carpenter is a lot more up to the job, and you see how he moves his iron back and forth to feed it in front of him.